Following an outcry made by Ugandans trapped in Myanmar, formerly known as Burma, the government, through the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, have embarked on the rescue plan, working with the government of Myanmar. The Minister of State for Foreign Affairs, John Malimba, says that they have learned from the government of Myanmar that Ugandans are trapped in a state which is under the siege by rebel groups, which makes the rescue plan more complicated.
The government of Myanmar, and we talked about this matter. He also expressed his deep sympathies to Ugandans who are there. Unfortunately, he said they are in rebel-held territory, and as a government, they also have little that they can do.
Malimba says they are also engaging international bodies like the United Nations to intervene and facilitate the rescue process. He explains that victims fell prey to cyber schemes which hoodwinked them that their destination was Malaysia.
We are therefore trying to put up heads together, government of Uganda, under the auspices of UN, with the government of Myanmar, to see how we can come up with a rescue plan. Because the people who are holding our Ugandans are criminals. Ugandans were deceived through labor export companies that they were being taken to Malaysia for jobs. And unfortunately, when they reached in Malaysia, I think they fell in wrong hands and they were trafficked to rebel-held territories. Of course, they didn't know where they were going. So we have to engage the international relations agencies, which are UN and other agencies, together with Myanmar, so that we can rescue Ugandans.
Malimba has faulted labor export companies for ignoring travel advisories and only care about money.
Some of them are simply not conscious. They simply hurry for money and not put the welfare of the people that they're exporting as labor in front. So we have discussed with the Minister of Labor, Social Development, to ensure that they awaken the labor companies who are involved in labor exports.
The opposition Shadow Minister for Foreign Affairs, Muadan Kunyinji, reported that victims are 450 in number. But the government has confirmed 30, but Malimba doesn't dispute the opposition figure, saying more distress calls are being made by victims.
Received credible information and numerous correspondences from victims that suggest that hundreds of Ugandan nationals, by my counting, estimated at 450 Ugandans, are being held as hostages in Myanmar by alleged labor groups for months now.
Which we are aware of, as of yesterday, was 30, those who were known to be. But of course, you know, trafficking is an illegal process. So people who end up in destination through trafficking, you may not have the accurate numbers. And number two, it's very difficult sometimes to get communication from where they are. Because I'm told, for a few that we have had, I think they still repicked phones and used WhatsApp to send. And it has been through relatives and other, you know, concerned parties who have been coming to us.
It is reported that Ugandans are not the only victims of Myanmar, but so are other East Africans. Travelers are lured as though they are going to Bangkok, Thailand, a popular destination for tourists and business. Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.